So hello, I'm Jonghyun Park of the Dury Clinic. Today I'm going to talk about treatment planning of the edentulous maxillar. So in case of the edentulous maxillar, for restoration, there could be four cases. First case is where you can use fixed prosthesis, so you have sufficient bone as well as lip support. Second case could be where you have enough bones, but there's a lack of lip support due to a lot of tissue loss. Third case with lip support is sufficient, but residual bone is not sufficient. Fourth and last case will be the bone is insufficient as well as the lip support. So for four cases, let's take a look at them one by one. So there are things to consider for maxillary edentulous restoration. There are many things to be considered. First is, you know, whether the bone is sufficient, aesthetic evaluation, distance in relationship, patient needs, economic requirements, and also requirements for opposing teeth. So a lot of things to be considered. Compared to mandibular, maxillary side, placing implant, if it's edentulous case, there is a lot of challenges. So first is when there's enough residual bone and also enough lip support. So it's an indication for fixed prosthesis. So in this case, fixed prosthesis needs to be used. If you use removables, then there could be different problems. One of the biggest problems would be that patient after restoration, they say their mouth is protruding. So there's not much of the alveolar bone resorption, and if you use dentures, of course, this can be the problem. The alveolar bone resorption is minimal, and if you use removable, and there is excessive resupport. So in insufficient space, if you do overdenture, not only have excessive resupport, then fracture and other problems can arise. So alveolar bone resorption is minimal, and if there's economic viability, then fixed prosthesis will be the best option. So there's not much bone resorption, the residual bone is sufficient. Then it's a fixed prosthesis indication. In such case, if you use overdenture as a compromise, then you could have a lot of problems on your hands. After implant placement, you know, abutment was connected and I did immediate loading. Aesthetic and functional problems were fixed in very short time. After 3 months, in conventional way, fixed prosthesis was delivered as the final prosthesis. So this is something you always think about. If you do restoration with fixed prosthesis, how many implants do you need to place where? So if this is V-shaped, then on the to reduce cantilever, I put arrow there. On the central incisor, it's favorable to put one more additional abutment implant there. It's more favorable the right side. If it's U-shaped, then on the anterior side, restoration with two implants could be an option. But like this, if to reduce cantilever volume, then in central incisor, adding one more implant would be more favorable. So if you do only up to first molar like this, total seven can be placed for final prosthesis. Using guide, seven implants were placed. And in three segments, final prosthesis were completed. So this is panorama picture. So like this, if you do in second molar, then 9 to 7 implants can be placed in three segments. That will be my favorable approach. Using guide, 9 fixtures were placed and I did immediate loading. 3 segments, final processes like this were completed. So final panorama picture. Now, on the maxillar side, smile line is very important. If it does not impact smile line, then to have more hygiene conditions, I use progingival margin up to where you can see in the smile line. Of course, I try not to show any metal, but there's no impact on the smile line. If that's that area and even the anterior maxillar side, using progingival margin, I create a final prosthesis. That is my preferred way. If oral hygiene can be well maintained, hence even after 6 years, it's very cleanly maintained. So this considered, so I used a class RPD, and that could be one option. On the both sides, two implants were placed. And RPD is covered by health insurance, and up to two implants is also covered by health insurance. Hence, you can do very attractive restorations. Cost-wise, functional-wise, you can maintain a lot of good successful results with this type of restoration. Next is where there's enough residual bone but insufficient lip support. So this are very tricky situation. Now, removable prosthesis to have favorable facial form, it might be helpful. If there's not sufficient rib support, if you have such thick denture flange, it can help give you more favorable facial form. Preserved rib support versus lost rib support needs to be considered choosing the right option, and this is very important area, so pay attention please. So smile line, of course, is also another important consideration. If it's indented maxillar, the prosthesis cannot be chosen based on the patient requirement. That's what Lagos said, and something that gives you a lot of takeaways. So vertical space, if it's too excessive, then and use fixed prosthesis, then oral hygiene management might be very difficult. So as I showed you in another lecture, it was done three years ago in another dentist. So filling all lost vertical space with fixed prosthesis, then oral hygiene management will be very difficult. So how do I restore in this case? I'm going to talk about that a bit later. If it's insufficient lip support, then removable prosthesis can be of help. So at least on the maxillar side, what this figure means, I think you will understand whether to go with overdenture, fixed hybrid denture, or fixed bridge, depending only based on patient requirement, is not the way to go. So on the upper and lower side, vertical dimension could be misinterpreted due to the horizontal relationship. You will understand more by looking that the vertical dimension has been reduced. In first glance, the lip support looks insufficient, but if you bite with a cut tendon and you can have a slight recovery of a vertical dimension, then you see there is actual rib support. So a fixed prosthesis might be a probable option. This support is not a bit lacking, but as a compromise, I did with this prosthesis, and it's after 2 years panorama photo. So again, let me give you a summary. Now, vertical dimension, if there's a loss, there are many patients like that, then in such case, you have to see whether there's sufficient rib support, and you should see also the relationship inside, and you have to have an accurate understanding of that. If there's insufficient rib support, I prefer hygienic type the best. This is not my case, but this is from the Gangwon-do University. Insufficient rib support was restored with hygienic type. So with ceramic metal, it was restored, and oral hygiene, with this can be managed better. If it's impacting smile line, then, of course, lost tissue area can be treated with pink porcelain. But if there's no impact on smile line, then all leaving as empty space could be, in terms of oral hygiene maintenance, be better. And also, like things, if there's a lot of tissue loss and or hygiene can be tricky, then pontic base shape is very important. If it's concave shape, then there could be a lot of plaque accumulating there, like this. So you have to remember this picture very well. If it's not concave, convex shape is better for plaque not being accumulated, and if possible like this, but 2 mm space needs to be given. That would be give you more favorable results. So can you, you know, understand if it's like convex pontic base in terms of oral hygiene management, it's more favorable. And if it's concave shape, oral hygiene maintenance will be very unfavorable. So you have to avoid it. You know, if it becomes concave, then plaque will accumulate and cannot escape. Hybrid type, if you use that prosthesis, then convex pontic design and wide embrasure space is two things you have to remember. It's very important, 2 points. So for me, if insufficient rib support, then fixed prosthesis, if the patient wants that, then rather hybrid type, because it's oral hygiene maintenance it worse, then I use the hygienic type. Of course, if it impacts smile line, patient would not like that, so you have to be careful. So this one says a lot of different things. Smile line, if there's impact to that, then like this, doing prosthesis, and then telling patient, oh, this is a successful result, then patient would really complain. So in this case, as I already shown you, pink porcelain can be used, and it's better to make as a hygienic time. If there's no impact to smile line, then, you know, for oral hygiene management, hygienic type would give you favorable results, more favorable result. There is the bone, but there is a lot of recession to use of denture for a long time after placing implant. I did immediate loading. Oral hygiene management for that, as much as possible, I created big embrasure, and I did use a supra gingiva margin and used hygienic type. So final prosthesis compared to removables, if you compare the two, you would know what I'm trying to say. Up to where smile line is seen, then as much as possible, I reduce margin to the gingiva side. But if it's smile line is not shown, then that area like this, I create with supra gingiva margin and try to open space as much as possible. This is the way more favorable hygiene, oral hygiene management. You know, clean prosthesis, which I as dentist cannot clean very well, and telling patients to clean that well is not very good. You have to create prosthesis where patient can keep it clean, will give you more aesthetic result. So because of the invisible area like smile line, just to create aesthetic result in the area you cannot see, creating prosthesis that is oral hygiene wise difficult to maintain is not right in my opinion. Next is there sufficient rib support but insufficient bone. So you could, you know, think about bone grafting. Lip support seems to be sufficient. And when you create temporary denture, there's excessive rib support. Then if you use removable here, the patient might complain about, you know, protruding mouth. So this is initial visit panorama. Insufficient amount posterior bone can be clearly seen. So with the bone grafting, restoration was done with the fixed prosthesis. Smile line, if it's not impacting that, then even the posterior side for oral hygiene maintenance, finishing with supra gingival margin is something I'm approaching different from other dentists. Where it's visible, I focus on aesthetics, but if it's invisible area like this, oral hygiene is my top priority consideration. So if there's not much of bone, therefore bone grafting cannot be done, then shortened dot technique is something I prefer. So, you know, like this type of restoration is something I also consider. On the right side, there's no restoration, but patient could still chew. And after 5 years, panorama photo, stably, implant is still functioning. So if there's insufficient bone and insufficient rib support, what to do? Let's look at it. So about, you could say, think about bar over denture. I didn't have a good case, so I borrowed from another professor. So using the splint bar, you could, you know, have a stable implant, and you could also have a better facial form. So it's a good option. So let me give you a summary. If you have enough residual bone as well as enough rib support, it's good indication for fixed prosthesis, but contraindication for overdenture. In overdenture being contraindication, if you understood even that one sentence, you have learned a lot through this lecture. In class 2, you could think about overdenture, and if patient wants fixed prosthesis, hygienic type is my favorite option because you can maintain oral hygiene better. And I hope you understand what the hygienic type is. It's important. In class 3, insufficient bone and sufficient lip support, you can do bone grafting or anterior implant and using RPD. On sufficient bone as well as insufficiently support, then bar over denture is something you can consider. So this has been the lecture for restoration of the edentulous and maxillary functional restoration. But sometimes you also think about the better facial form, so it's a very challenging situation. Oral hygiene management is also very important. So these things all need to be considered in getting the treatment plan so that you could have a good successful result. With that, I'd like to finish this lecture. Thank you very much.